Charis Missionary Church. As a place of happiness, a place of grace, a place of worship, a place of salvation.
How do we know a prophet?
A prophet must prophesy himself first before he
prophesies. Amen.
People will say you're a prophet because whatever you say about yourself, it will come to pass. Now they'll come and beg you. Please, can you tell, speak something to me? It will happen also. Two, be careful what you think. Because whatever you think, it won't be your mind, it will be the mind of God. Paul says, we have got mind of Christ. We have mind of what? Of Christ. So you be careful what you think. If there is any negative thought, deny it very quickly. Because many times God will speak with you through thoughts, will direct you. There will be a master plan which is coming from your mind. Whatever you think is genuine and perfect. So if you are thinking about building a house, draw a plan, even if you can't
draw.
The architecture will come and say, this is perfect. I've never seen it anywhere. God wants you to do a new thing. So, in your thoughts, there will be new ideas. I don't know if you're hearing me. In your thoughts, there will be new what? Ideas. Because of the anointing. Anointing ponders new things to happen. It drives you to a place where you have to surprise your neighbor. The reason why people can worship your God is because they have not seen a new thing on you. So anointing will give you a thought. In that thought, you write it down. Because it will produce a new thing. And that new thing, it will be created to be a real thing. So that everybody will see it. In other words, you are going to be a chase setter. So be careful what you think. Be careful what you think. So whatever you think, it will come to pass. Whatever you think, it's not you thinking, it's God speaking. I don't know if you're hearing me. If you think about
America,
so you must sit down and say, why am I thinking about America? It means God wanted me to go there. And from there, God will create strategies of making you to go there. And you will go there in Jesus' name. Can I say something to you? Our problem, we are undermining ourselves. Where does undermining come from? We have tried on our own and we fail. And we cannot try again. So we undermine ourselves. Undermine came because you try on your own, you fail. Sometimes when you fail, you didn't fail, it's because you were thinking something that is not supposed to happen. And God wants you to do bigger things than that. So you fail because you think about small things. And whereas God wants you to produce big things. So touch them, my friend. Whatever I think, I write it down. I just write it down. So, anointing will make you to come out. Are you hearing me? With ideas that will make people to celebrate you. This year, you must be celebrated.
Amen.
If you believe, shout hallelujah. How many of you want anointing? Just wave your hand. You want anointing? Congratulations. Thank you. How many of you knows that by receiving anointing, just anointing, you will feel it way forward. And from there, you will break all barriers in your family. That's what I meant
you
to. It does not make you to think only. Number three, it makes you to break all barriers in your family, in your village, in your city. You can be born in the village, you become a leader in the city because of anointing. That's number three. Say, I'll break all my barriers. What is a barrier? In your family, you are bound to reach here. But because of it, you pass there. You pass there. Listen to this. Can you check Christians who have been raised by God? Many of them were useless in the family. Rejected in the family. But because of the anointing, God makes them to break that barrier. Many people, according to the wisdom of the world, they are not even there. But because of anointing, they break a barrier and they reach on the other side like you today. Today, I don't care what is happening in your life, but because of the anointing that will descend in this place, you will break a barrier and live beyond the expectations. Okay, let me show you in the Word of God. Maybe you will understand. Show you from verses and other things. I was just talking. This is God's talking. Make you to understand that when anointing come today, what will happen? If you read First Samuel, and you read 10,
Mola, chapter 10,
from verse 1 to 9.
Latoma verse 1 ufitela mola verse 9.
First
Samuel.
Samuel
wapili.
Chapter 10,
verse 1 to 9.
Then Samuel took the vial of oil and poured it upon his head and kissed him and said, "Is it not that Jehovah hath anointed thee to be prince over his inheritance? When thou art depart from me today, then thou shalt find two men by Rachel's capture in the border of Benjamin at Zelzah, and they will say unto thee, the donkeys which thou wentest to seek are found. And lo, thy father has left off caring for the donkeys and is anxious for you, saying, what shall I do for my son? Then shalt thou go on forward from thence, and thou shalt come to the oak of Tabor, and there shall meet thee three men going up to go to Bethel, one carrying three keys, and another carrying three loaves of bread, and another carrying a bottle of wine. And they will salute thee." Yeah, I love it. "They will salute thee."
Amen.
"And give thee two loaves of bread, which thou shalt receive of their hand." In other words, you won't ask, you won't beg here. "After thou shalt come to the hill of God, where is the garrison of the Philistine, it shall come to pass when thou art come thither to the city, that thou shalt meet a band of prophets coming down from the high place with a psaltery and a timbrel and a pipe and a harp before them, and they will be prophesying. And the Spirit of Jehovah will come mightily upon thee, and thou shalt prophesy with them, and shall be turned into another man. And let it be, when these signs are come unto thee, that thou do an occasion shall serve thee, for God is with thee. And thou shalt go down before the Gilgal, and behold, I will come down unto thee to offer burnt offerings and to sacrifices of peace offering. 7 days shalt thou tarry till I come unto thee and show thee what what thou shalt do. If you read verse 9, and it was so that when he had turned his back to go from Samuel, God gave him another heart, and all those signs came to pass that day. Let's pray. Father, thank you for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I believe this is not new to you, because you've been reading this several times. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But if you can see, the people are supposed to carry oil because of God. Such people were prophets. Prophets. They carry that oil. So you can see that these prophets who carry oil, he had a direction of where to go, whom to anoint, and for what. So, issue here is not just being anointed, but it's for certain assignment. So you can see that, you know, the oil, when it comes upon your head, it does not just come. It just comes for an assignment in life. Assignment in life. You have got an assignment in life, but you need an oil. Yeah, you can see that the last verse we read, verse 9 especially, that what has happened there was after prophet spoke what will happen. The first thing he poured the oil, and he spoke the ways that will come to pass. And what happened was the changing of the heart. You know, here I wanted to listen very carefully that already our situations of life, you can find that are not changing because our hearts are not changing. Can you see there are three things that has happened? Number one, he had a vial of oil, a pour. Two, after he did that, he spoke what will happen. Three, the changing of the heart. Because the changing of heart happened when this man turned. If you can see the issue of turning here, you will understand that the changing of the hearts was also the changing of perspectives, changing of ideas, changing of, I mean, how you think, what you think, and forget about where you were born and what happened to you. When God changes
that,
when he came, he was still the same man. When the oil was poured on him, he was still the same man. But when he turned, he was no longer the same man. Many of you are still the same people how you came. You know your problem. You know what is happening. You know everything about yourself. But when you turn from here because of anointing, your heart will change to suit the assignment that God has created you for. So that whatever that God is assigning you for must come to pass. Otherwise, nothing will happen. I don't know if you're hearing me. So the changing of the heart, it happens when you turn from the prophet. But you turn with anointing. And then everything you think about you change. Failure, change. Worry, change. Past, change. Difficulty, change. Pain, change. And you go as a new man. And everything began to happen. Everything came to pass after this man was changed. Today, you'll be changed. I said, today you'll be changed. Listen, you can meet the prophet and you remain the same.
But
not when you turn
from the prophet.
Not when you turn from the prophet. When you are sitting, you'll be thinking about what has happened yesterday, your situation, your trouble, whatever. But
the oil
on top of you will crush everything when you turn. It will be like a total turnaround. As you turn, things will turn. Tazos are hey. If, when you turn, things will turn. And you are becoming a new man. Yeah, this man, God was putting him in an office where he's going to be in charge of his inheritance. In other words, anointing, putting in an office where you are going to be responsible. I don't know if you're hearing me. There is a responsibility that God is giving you, and he must put you in that office. If not, you don't know where you are supposed to execute your abilities because you are not responsible of anything. I don't know if you're hearing that. If you look at this one now, also in 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 13, you find that when God anoints David, verse 13, let's go to 16. Maybe you'll understand what I'm saying.
16, verse,
yes. Then Samuel, the same prophet, took a horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the spirit of Jehovah came mightily upon David from that day forward. Can you see the verse there? You know, here is now God was saying, this man, I know I anointed him. But it doesn't go by nature. Because some people, when you are, we grieve God too much when we are anointed. We don't go by nature. We forget what came upon us. But if somebody knows that he has anointed you, he was a vessel to anoint you, he will never stop praying for you until. But here, Samuel was carrying on praying for one man. God, you have anointed this man, but it's no longer going by anointing. Please, help him. Please, make him to realize he's sinning against you, because he needs to believe in anointing. Listen, once you receive anointing, you must believe in anointing. Believe that it's not your ability that makes to achieve what you can achieve in life. If you think you can achieve what you're achieving because of you, automatically you are kicking God away. And from there, you are going to meet some challenges that you never saw. Like Saul, after he was anointed, he went by his ideas, his plan, whatever he can do. Sometimes when you see where he can go, you just go there. When you want to do, he went by people. If you can read where we have read, it says, Samuel said, you know what, you can wait for me. I will come and sacrifice. In chapter 10. But you know, the Bible says he never waited. When you see people going, he went by people, he forget anointing. Because anointing with people, they are two different things. You know, listen to this. If you are anointed, you forget people. You go by what God says. If they reject you, you are still connected where God is connecting you. So, where we have read now, in chapter 16, is when Samuel was sent by God and said, God, stop crying for this man I've rejected. Go to the house of Jesse. I've provided myself a prophet or a king for my people. All right. This is an office I want to give you.
All
right, look here. Always, God does not just anoint people. Always, you must know that anointing doesn't just come for. It's not there to make you to be excited. You know, some people when I need to come, they just but laugh. It's not there to make you to laugh. It's for assignment. You know what happened that day? This man took a horn. A horn is something like this. He poured oil. He went to the house of Joseph. A horn. You carry it. And carry it there. And God said, anoint David. He anointed David in the midst of his brothers. You know, I was so challenged here when I thought that God can still anoint you. And you find that he's anointing this one, you are sitting around, but it's not anointing. You know, here, it's a challenge to me. Today when we are anointing you, you know how you know you are anointed? When you tell, you forget pain, worry, shame, poverty, lack. You forget. But that anointing can be useless if you are still taking the past yourself. I don't know if you are hearing me. Because can you see anointing coming upon this boy and his brothers were there? And the Bible said the Spirit of the Mighty God rested upon him forward. He never left the presence of the living God. And the Holy Spirit was upon him way forward. I don't know how I can explain this to you. Anointing with the Holy Spirit, they go hand in hand. I don't know if you're hearing me. Are you hearing me? When we anoint you today, it's a sign of the presence of the Holy Spirit upon your life. Possibly it means the Holy Spirit will enter you and stay in you and direct you. But if you don't get direction from the Holy Spirit, you'll go by people. You'll just go by people. From there you'll be rejected. Today you are receiving anointing. Say, I'm receiving anointing. When David received anointing, oil, the Spirit of the living God came upon him. Look at that verse again. It says, then Samuel 13 took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. Amen. My God. And the Spirit of Jehovah came mightily upon him. And from that day forward, it means moving forward. After I've read this, I'm still worried. God help us so that we must not anoint others. And you find others are not anointed. I'm sure you understand what I'm trying to say.
Amen.
God help us today so that when the oil came upon everyone here, all of us here, we will never fail to our assignment. Because it's when now the Spirit of God came upon us and way forward. There's something that I was realizing that some people, they don't know.
Which,
do you know that anointing attracts everything? Anointing can attract enemies. It can attract friends. It can attract money. It can attract poverty. So there are things that when are being attracted, there is Holy Spirit in you now. Not only anointing upon you. Holy Spirit will say, this is not yours. I don't know if you're hearing me. This is not what?
Yours.
Don't take this. This will make you to be rejected by the one who anointed you. Do you know that what happened one day after Saul was anointed? When he went to fight, he took things which were fed like the sheep that were fed. He was given an assignment, go and destroy everything. When he reached there, he said, this one I can't leave. I'm not stupid. You see, I've rejected this man. Because anointing attracts the fed and the theme. Sometimes, you know, anointing can take you to a place where you don't want. Because look what happened to David. After David was anointed, the Bible says he went to Adullam. In Adullam, it was a cave. And the people were distressed.
Sometimes
anointing doesn't mean that from way forward, things will run smooth. God must train you. You must train your fingers how to fight. David was taken to a place where when his people were rejecting him, the king was fighting him. He ran to
Adullam
and stayed with the people who have been rejected, distressed, and he became leader because of the anointing. They become big army. Can I say something to you? Sometimes anointing can take you to where you are not expecting, but where you are not expecting, that's where you are needed. Stop putting yourself where you are not needed. Tell the neighbor, stop putting yourself where you are not needed. The place where you are not needed is a place where things can materialize around your life. There are places where I am not needed. If I put myself there at zero. So David put himself, he realized that if he's there, try to help the king by playing a harp. And the king had evil spirit and take a shot. Many people are receiving some shots because they are in the wrong place. Anointing can take you out for a while and bring you back as a leader. There are some people that God is taking them for a while, but they are coming back as a leader. Pastor say, hey, I'm taken out, but it's not over. I'm written off, but it's not final. I'm rejected, but it's not over. When I come back, when I bounce back, I will shock you. But the anointing that is upon my life, that's what I say, hey, I'm bouncing back. So it makes me to laugh. So when you're God anointing, you must be rejected so that you become the head. Jephthah was rejected by the brethren, but they searched for him.
Joseph
was sold, but he becomes the leader. There are people who are rejected who are not needed. You need anointing to prove your enemy wrong. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Say, I need anointing. I need an oil. Tessa, I need an oil. Because many times you ask yourself, but
what kind of things are these?
Why
are my things not going the right way? I'm trying. I'm working, I'm going up and down. Just to buy a wardrobe.
It's a little color.
Is still you're still owing that wardrobe even today.
Mara we sell it.
Mara the doors of the wardrobe are now falling. You're buying this one goes wrong. You are trying to patch this other side, cracks are coming out on.
When you, 6 months.
Well, you are buying a bed, when you are trying to sleep on top of the bed break. You don't have even insurance for the bed.
I mean, everything you try to do, you end up saying, but why me? Why when I try this,
why I fail?
You need an oil.
Utoka oli wana papa.
You just need a one?
Utoka makura.
Oil.
Makura fela.
Just need simple thing.
Utoka nolo fela wana papa.
Oil from the Holy Spirit.
Makura moyo halalela.
That will bring the Holy Spirit upon you.
But
let me just show you some scriptures and we close. If you read Psalm 89 verse
20.
I love the book of Psalms. I need an oil. I'm tired of hands. Verse what? 20.
Verse 20.
I have found, it was God speaking, David my servant. With my holy oil I have anointed him, with whom my hand shall be established. Mine arm also shall strengthen him.
Amen.
The enemy shall not extract from him, nor son of wickedness afflict him. And I will beat down his adversaries.
Amen.
Before him.
Amen.
Them that hate him.
Amen.
Can you see what will happen?
Yeah, what I'm talking about here.
When you are anointed by the oil from God. Number one day, what will happen? God will establish you. Two, no one will be able to remove you. Three, those who try to afflict you, they will fail. Four, your adversaries will be beaten down. This is the time of living your life. I said, this is the time of living your life. Five, those who hate you will be smitten. So you can see what anointing comes. I understand it now that somebody who fights the anointed is fighting the living God. That's what the Bible says, do not fight my anointed.
Eh?
So you can see when God anoints today, there's no affliction. Those who hate you, they get
basela.
Those who are trying to do whatever they are doing, it's like they are doing on themselves. You are about to smile
yourself.
I say you are about to smile yourself. I want to smile
myself.
You know, if this thing can happen, here God was speaking, he said, I've anointed a man called David with my oil. Number one. I'm saying it again. Number one. Because of the anointing, you will be established. Number two. No one will remove him. No one. You see, enemies are there to remove. Number three. No wicked people will afflict him. The enemy's adversaries, when they try to fight him, God will beat them down. Number five, those who hate him, they will be smitten. Think about it. This is anointing. In other words, from today, when you hear a noise in the house when you are sleeping, carry on pulling your
your
blankets and sleep and rest and thank your God. You can't fight for yourself again. No one will be able to defeat you. No one will be able to remove you. No one will be able to stop you. You are unbreakable, unstoppable. You are a child of the living God. If you read this verse, Psalm 23, is when, you know, Psalm 23:1-6 there. The Lord is your shepherd. The Lord is your shepherd. You shall not want. If you can look at that, it says, it means, even if you are lacking now, you are not lacking. That's what I say, my friend. I look like I'm lacking, but I'm not lacking. Jehovah is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restore my souls. Look at this verse where he says, yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me. Thou prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou hast anointed my head with oil. and my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. That's the reason why you are in the house of God today. I shall dwell in the house of God. I shall glorify him because of what he has done. I won't look back of what he's doing. I won't look back on what devil was doing. Why? Because I know there is oil, 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 oil. You need an oil today. So your cup will run over.
Sinolo saga osia falala.
Oil is there.
Oli iteng makura.
For everything.
Udiela diluche kamka kamka.
If you read James, the book of James, chapter
5,
you see that it's also there for healing.
Otla bona uri le ona igona udiela podisho.
Let's go for James.
Ari e Jacob.
Chapter 5 verse 14.
Chapter 5 verse 14.
It says if you are sick, call the elders of the church to anoint you with oil and you shall be healed. I want us to look carefully on that verse because many times we are reading verses and
can you
look at that 14?
He
says, if anyone among you is sick, let him call for the leaders or elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of what? Of the Lord. Look at verse
15.
And the prayer of faith shall save him that is sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if you have committed sins, it shall forgiven him.
Mithapelo ya tumelo itlo pulusha molwetse morena o tlo motsusha ga dirile dibi o tlo lebalelwa.
There are two things we are missing when we read there.
We
read only that verse
14.
We forget about 15.
Ra lebala ka verse 15.
This is one thing. It says elders. Elders of the church. In other words, when you need oil, you don't need one person, you need elders.
But
in elders of the church, one of them must have faith. He will pray a prayer of faith from the elders of the church. One of them must have faith. You know, the Bible says two things there. If you can read verse 15, it says, and the prayer, let me read 14, maybe you will see it. Is anyone, any among you sick, let him call for the elders of the church. Let them pray. Can you see them? Then pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. Yeah, first we say, and the prayer of faith shall save him that is sick. What is important is the prayer. If the elders are seven, one of them will go prayer of faith that will save the sick. What is important here is, and the Lord shall raise him up. To be raised by God is to go to where you are supposed to be. Oil is there for restoration. And he says, the prayer will raise him up. And if he committed sins, will be forgiven. Two things. Can you see that? A prayer with oil can make your sins to be forgiven. Not only that, also to be restored back to your original position. Raise up. There are some people that God wants to raise today. You are the one who's here. I say you are the one that God is raising. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Say God is raising me. I will never fall again. I have prayer of faith to you. No, I'm speaking. I say I've got prayer of faith today. I will anoint you with oil. Two things, restoration, God will raise you, and also God will forgive you. You are becoming a new creature. If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Clap hands for yourself.
I reach a feeling matter.
We have visitors from Namibia.
All
of them, we can stand Namibia.
Kaofela ba kaemele.
That's it. You can see their flags. You can see it's wonderful. Can you just wave your flags? Yes. Thank you. God bless you. God bless you. You can sit down.
Remember,
we have pastors here. You can stand, pastors who are here. You are very much lucky to attend this service. It's the grace of God for you. It's the grace of God. Welcome.
I greet everybody in the name of Jesus.
2 weeks back, Bengila as a visitor.
I was here as a visitor.
Bengne problem ye fibroid.
I had a problem with fibroids. After I saw Apostle.
Mangfike ekhaya Thursday.
When I got home on Thursday.
Friday morning extending yenga thola ama period one because they were blocked the whole month.
Ka mesong ya labotlhano ke ile ka bona matjatji aka ka lebaka la gore be ke sa bone e dikgwedi tse dintsi.
Ngizobonga amandla kaNkulunkulu ngibonga Apostle ukuthi akhona ukumamela uNkulunkulu amsebenze ngendlela uNkulunkulu afuna ukumsebenzisa ngayo ngiyabonga.
I'm here to thank God for the life of Apostle. Amen.
Thank you. I greet you all in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord.
Ke le dumedisa ka monga ka lena la Jesu Kriste.
Amen. I would like to thank God because God, my name is Prophetess Notira. God cancelled my debt after I pledged 1,000 for Charis TV.
Kerata go leboa modimo ba phumotse dikoloto tsa ka moka ka moraga gore ke ntshe pledge ya Charis TV PlayStation.
I ask God to expose every hidden demon in me.
Ke le ka gopela modimo gore ba tsweletse sesengwe le sesengwe se sempe mo go nna.
And God exposed those credits. They were for credits from 2012 because I owed a flat.
Ka nnete modimo ile ba ditsweletse e be ile dikoloto ka moka tsebe ke dikoloto go tloga ka 2012 ile flat.
I would like to thank God. Amen.
Ke rata go leboa modimo ka sengwe. I greet everybody in the name of Jesus Christ.
On Monday,
they
were involved in a car accident.
Where somebody bumped us from the back. We had the Charis sticker on our car, and all of us, we survived. I thank God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. I would like to thank God for restoring my marriage. I
would
also like to thank God
for
changing my husband.
He used
to drink a lot.
Even
lose respect.
And
I thank God he's no longer drinking
anymore.
I'd also like to thank God.
He used to have
a
pain.
My husband for years.
We thought it's
because he's a driver. So one
day,
after church,
he
told me to pray for him.
He
was crying.
So
I gave him anointing
water.
And after that, I threw the anointing water on the
back. And he
was screaming
and crying.
And he said,
the
water was not as cold
when
he was drinking.
But
now it feels like it's a cold, it's ice blocks on his
back.
From that day,
the pain
is gone. We thank God.
Amen. I would Amen.
Like to greet everybody in the name of Jesus.
I started
coming here when I had a painful hand for
2 years.
My hand was not working properly. I had cramps and pains as well.
Now
I thank God because on the 25th of April,
this site, it was on Friday.
I was seated there at the back. It was on a Friday and we were worshipping.
And then
I felt somebody pulling my fingers. They were very painful.
And then the following day, and
the following morning, my hand was healed. Up until today, I'm still healed, and I thank God for that. I greet everybody in the name of Jesus Christ. I came here on the 5th of July. I was very sick and I was having dizziness. I just bought Charis anointing water. After drinking the water, the dizziness went away. Even now I'm healed, I'm no longer feeling the dizziness. After that, I was given a new car, which is a four-wheel drive. I'm thanking God for what he has done for me. Zina la goro in the mini.
A Hyundai 2.2 CRDI.
Amen.
A four-wheel drive.
Dumela le kae?
Hallelujah.
Arete. Ke tle mona ka one-on-one about a month ago.
I came here for a one-on-one session with Apostle a month ago.
I had problems at work. Basically,
yeah,
with my managers, and then they wanted to get me fired. So after the
one-on-one,
in the mix of everything, while I was getting tired to get fired, everything changed. I got a promotion. I got I'm looking at close above half a million. That was increased on my package, going to a million.
Amen.
A lot of things changed. I'd like to thank the Lord. Thanks a lot.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I greet you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I am here to thank God for what has done in my family. I'm here to thank God because I am the first person to get married in my family. And in that same month, I got an increase at work. Amen. I'm greeting you in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I'm here to thank God. Because this servant prophesied me last year that I have been tied in my womb. And he also told me who did this thing to me.
And then one three boys.
He prayed for me and he said he's seeing three boys. Now I am thanking God because God has blessed me with a baby boy on the 28th of last month. Amen.
Darling, let's clap hands for Jesus. All right. If we can ask that lady concerning the issue of the baby. How long you were searching for children? Let's see. How long you wanted a child?
From 2013,
so we're seeing funa.
We married in 2013 and we've been searching for the fruit of the womb ever since then.
So now you have the first boy. There are two.
There are two.
So you are left with one?
Yes.
Oh. All right. There are two. You got one. Now you are left with one. Oh. You don't want a girl.
I wouldn't tombazan. She you says know, she's the one I'm looking for next.
Because you've got two boys.
Yes.
So there will be a boy, the third one. And the girl will come, number four.
Amen.
Amen.
You know, many times we don't know what God has created us for. We just say we want, like myself, if I knew I was supposed to be having many children, if I knew. But most of the time I would just say, God, give me children, give me children. God knows, I know. Sometimes you ask and you don't know what God wants to give you. Are you hearing me? Like herself, one child, now she got a boy. There's another boy coming. There's a girl coming, the last one. So there are four. So she has been destined to have four children. Like myself, I'm destined to have three children. Sometimes you are destined to have one child. I mean, it's not what you ask for. But you can still go and ask and say, God, I want a child, I don't have a child. God will give you. Are you hearing me? But herself also, she was destined to have four, but Satan was blocking. Only one child. She had one child. So God gave her now. So she must believe that even if she tried to stop the girl, she cried to get a girl, she will find a boy. But the girl is number four. So she has got no choice. And there's a reason why. They say, where is your husband? There's a reason why, my brother. My brother, there's a reason why. Can I tell you the reason?
The name of God.
All right. God has called you to have branches.
Amen.
And listen, God wants to raise children from you, boys, that will preach the gospel, that will do the work of God, that will reach many people. I mean, what you are doing now is only deliverance.
Yes, man of God. That is true. That is true.
But the children that are coming are prophets.
Amen!
So, can you see how God does? Can you see how God does? Children comes from God. They're not coming from you. They come from where? From God. So, brother, like this child you are carrying. This child here is a prophet. This child.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
If I lift my hand to God, God will give you the anointing.
Amen.
And what will happen? Nothing will happen to your children.
Amen.
Because the first one you had was sick.
Amen.
Eh?
Amen.
You remember?
Amen.
As if the devil wants to destroy everything.
Amen.
But thank God you came here. Healed. Second child. The third one is coming. The fourth one that is will be the girl that will help you.
Amen.
To cook around. brother, bring your car here. Where is the brother? Bring your car. It's wonderful to have people still giving us testimonies of cars. Ask them, where is your car? Say it is parked outside. Don't say I don't have. Say it's parked outside. Tell the person the name of the car. Don't say I don't have. Say my car is parked outside. Don't say I come with my husband. Say I came alone with my own car. That is faith. Iha nyama halaka Jesu hina.
Iha nyama la.
Oh.
Iha nyama. Endenika evangelile.
Iha ni. Le mahala ka Jesu
ihanya ma oh ihanya mahala
next week. Can you dance like one? Of the God. Thank you.
Arequeng, let us hear what they have to say about what God has blessed them with. I really want to thank God. What God has done for me. I never thought it this way. But now, because I've seen that God has got love, I really want to thank him. Hallelujah. Clap your hands and ululate. Bless the name of the Most High God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I just love to thank the Lord. I was driving Toyota Corolla. He was always saying, my wife, you are of bigger size. You have to find a bigger car. So when we were here on the 5th, he said everyone must get whatever he's thinking of. So did he just woke up in the morning and went to another garage and said to me, when he come back, I got a car for you? He was not even qualifying to buy the car. Now today I'm driving a bigger car because of the love of the Lord. I'm no longer going to drive around with my Corolla. So I really want to thank the Lord for giving me a husband like this one. He is driving BMW and now I'm driving Corolla Toyota. I really love to thank the God of Charis for what he has done. Hallelujah! Can you ululate? You clap your hands, shout! Scream and glorify the name of the Lord. jealous I show me one up, Papa. I go shape my talk. Clap your hands, shout and scream and glorify the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Aba ribudzo uri ipfi mini dzina layo na khala.
Ipfi Hyundai Santa Fe.
Yo.
2.2 CRDI the four wheel drive.
Yo na mawe. Aba dzobolos.
E Hyundai Santa Fe.
Hyundai Santa Fe likwile.
2.2 diesel.
2.2 diesel. Hey.
Metallic blue color.
Color, they say it's metal. Marai metallic blue as yon. Marai metallic blue. Hallelujah. Nice aliki ba mo charisi. Santa Fe kitomalu iikwa. Kwa la niti. Ako busha mtu lenga for Santa Fe yo na ungele wa ito. Na kitomo ito. Mara tuteli na li jealous lina. Hallelujah. Ari seng matoari na mokole. Let us put our hands to the car and we bless the car. Let us all say, in the name of Jesus, you have found favor in the eyes of the Lord. We cover this car by the blood of Jesus. You will never lack finance to pour petrol in this car. You will never open the front of this car in Jesus' name. You will never stuck along the road in the name of Jesus. And you will never make an accident with this car. In Jesus' mighty name. So shall it be in the name of Jesus. Amen. Clap your hands, ululate. They shall be reversing their car. Hallelujah. I am a reverse Santa Fe. I was wrong. But let me tell you, I'm not Santa Fe. I'm not Santa Fe. Ya marali ya babona mama kara Toyota Corolla batho ba mudimo. Mudimo a tsharisa lokile ke a lebotsa. Hallelujah. Can you ululate when the car is reversing? Ari 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 Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus.
So how many of you knows that by me coming here, the anointing is coming to bring a change? How many of you knows that?
Amen.
Are you expecting a change?
Amen.
Are you sure?
Amen.
Can I get 1% who just need healing today of HIV. HIV? Is it HIV?
Amen.
Take it. You are free. Amen. Can I get another one that side? One healing. Just run. Please, 1%. 1%. You are healed. You are healed. You are healed. You can see a face here. Look at her face here. Look at her face of because of HIV. Can I get HIV? One this side?
HIV, come.
You are free. You can go for a test. When mere touch, it can change your life.
Amen.
Can I get one of diabetes?
What diabetes?
One person, come, Mama. God has healed you, Mama. God has healed you. How long you are diabetic? 2 years. You are free. Can I get one here of diabetes?
What diabetes?
Are you diabetic, Mama? Eh? Mama, you are here. You can see what is happening to Mama here. Can I get one that side who wants a job? One. Fall down. In Jesus' name, you are free. What is happening? You don't know what happened. You don't know what happened?
Yeah.
Can you stand up? She doesn't even know what happened. Stand up.
MLN.
Look at that one falling. Hey, fall down. You, fall down also. You are going there. Fall down. Can you stand up? Look at this one. She can't stand again. You are free. Stand up now, you will stand now. She got a job. Can I get one person who doesn't want a job? All right, can I get one person who want a job here? Fall down. Jesus' name. Down, down, down. Come on down. Come on. Down. In Jesus' name, you are blessed.
Amen.
Can I get one person here who want to marry? Oh, down. Oh, 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 oh. Come on. Down. All of it down. The mighty name of Jesus Christ. Poof. Hey. Poof. Brother, fall down. Poof. 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 In Jesus' name, you're Amen. Free. You're all free. Jesus is blessing you.
Amen.
Can I get... How many of you want cars? Lift up. Yeah. If you want a car, lift up your hands. Hey. Take the camera. Just lift up your hands. Holy Ghost, bring all who want cars here. Touch them wherever they are. Touch. Touch wherever you are. Touch. Touch. Watch, watch, watch. Watch what God is doing. Watch. Watch. All who are receiving a card this week, receive that touch. Pa. Phew. I see BMW. I see BMW. I see people touch because of BMW. I see Mercedes now. I see Range Rover now. Look at that brother. Look at the brother there. Look at the brother there. Look at the anointing. What the anointing can do. You are receiving a car. You are receiving your car. You are receive a house.
I receive.
There are others who are receiving houses now. Houses, 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 houses.
Amen.
Houses, houses,
Amen.
Houses. Holy Ghost, can you touch them? Bring them out. Bring them out. Let me see them. I count three. One, two, three. Ashes, ashes, ashes. Many people. You will see them falling.
Thank you, Jesus.
Arise. There's a house. Somebody's buying you a house. Somebody's Amen. Buying you a house.
Amen.
Somebody's buying you a house.
Amen.
Somebody, yeah, yeah, yeah. Somebody
Amen.
Wants to build you a house.
Amen.
Somebody, I see
Amen.
Houses. I see houses.
Amen.
Oh, Jesus. Can you bring those who have been marketing jobs and they are not getting them? Touch them wherever they are. Bring them here now. I count three. One. Two. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. Wherever they are. Two, three. Arise, arise. Some people have fallen down there.
Sizothini. Watch this lady. Watch. My God. Look at this one. My God. Arise. If you say there is no Holy Spirit, I'm just speaking. Bring this one. It happened. If you are there and you are struggling with depths, Holy Ghost, bring them here. Touch them. Amen. Break the depths. Amen. Break those depths. Touch them. Watch. My God. Any depth of a car, of a house, close. If you have got any depth, receive that touch. Amen. I cancel that depth. I cancel the depth. I cancel. Amen. I cancel. Amen. I cancel. I cancel. I cancel.
Amen.
Watch there. My God. Alright. Phew. The fire is increasing now. Amen. Look on this one who are sitting here. Look at them. They are vibrating. They will vibrate more. They will vibrate more. More vibration. They will vibrate more. Something is coming out of their bodies. Bad luck is going. Failure is going. Shame is going. Poverty is running out. Everything is going away. Oh my God. That demon that was blocking the family is going away right now.
Amen.
Arise. Arise. Father, can you touch those in the family? They want to do a new thing. But always the family, there's a line that of a curse that has been drawn by witches and wizards. Right now, touch those people. Let me see. Yeah, watch that lady there. Watch that lady, my God. The family, there's witches and wizards. In the family, the demon that has hidden because of witchcraft, I command that demon to manifest right now.
Amen.
I say, you demon of witchcraft, I command you. Hey, I command you. Catch fire. I say, catch fire, you demon of witchcraft. If you are blocked in the family, because of witchcraft, I command that witchcraft issue to leave you right now.
Amen.
If they've wished you, they are leaving you right now.
Amen.
I said they are leaving you right now.
Amen.
They are leaving you right now.
Amen.
Witchcraft, witches and wizards are running away from you.
Amen.
They wish you that you must not live your life.
Amen.
Today they are living your life.
Amen.
They are living your life.
Amen.
They are living your life.
Amen.
They are living your life. They are Amen. Living your life. They are trying to give you things when you are asleep. They try to feed you. They try to block you. I command whatever they've given you to come out of you.
Amen.
To come out of you.
Amen.
I said to come out of you.
Amen.
To come out of you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There are some people that are receiving healing now. Healing right now. Whatever situation is in your body is leaving your body right now.
Amen.
It's leaving your body right now.
Amen.
I say any disease that is holding your life is coming out right now.
Amen.
It's coming out right now.
Amen.
Whatever they put in your body to make you sick, right now it's coming out.
Amen.
I say it's coming out.
Amen.
It's coming out.
Amen.
Out.
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 Out. Out. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Out. 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 Come 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 out. 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 Out.
In Jesus.
Amen.
If they put something in your stomach,
in your womb, in your private life. It's coming out right now, right now, right now. There's something that is coming out right now. I see it coming out. I say, now, 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 now. Fibroid out.
Out.
Moving object out.
Out.
I say, come on, come on, come on, come on, right now.
Out, 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 out. Out, 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 out.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Any evil animal in your body, come out.
Out.
In your documents, come out.
Out.
In your career, come out.
Out.
Any snake, lizard, whatever they put in your life, come out.
Out.
Any spiritual husband and wife, come out.
Out.
Any evil bird that is monitoring you, come out.
Out.
Whatever that is looking on you, so that you may be blocked in your destiny, is leaving you right now. Come out.
Out.
I can't hear you.
Out.
I can't hear anything.
Out.
Carry on. Watch, watch, watch. Jesus.
Amen.
You know, our God is faithful. Let this man, is he from Namibia? Yeah? He's healed now. Let him walk without crutches. Let him walk now. He's walking now. Let him walk now. Can you hold those two crutches? Let him walk. Walk.
Sipila.
Walk.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes.
Let him walk.
Hallelujah.
No one does you wanna. Carry on. Listen, how long is like this? Let me hear.
Can I wake up?
You are his wife? How long is like this?
2 years.
2 years.
2 years.
He could not walk without crutches.
He cannot walk.
He can't walk. So can you see how he's walking now? Is it the first time you see him like this?
Yes. It's the first time now.
You people, Jesus. You think when we say walk, Jesus. Look at him, he's walking. They say Jesus. 2 years.
Jesus.
2 years, he's using crutches from Namibia. Is the first time his wife, you see him walking. Walk, walk, Baba, walk, walk, walk. Walk.
Hallelujah.
2 years.
My God, hallelujah.
You can hear the wife praising the living God.
Hallelujah, I want to praise you. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I give you glory, my God. Hallelujah. The pain is down,
hallelujah.
My Father, my God. The pain is down in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. 2 years. 2 years. Baba is walking.
Papa ba sepele.
And that leg, that right leg, God is strengthening it. God, as he's walking, he's still going to be more strong.
2 years.
What happened to Baba Mama? Where is the mama we are talking about? Let's hear the husband. I'm sure she's tired. I don't want people who can sit in the church. I want people to stand up. You've been standing everywhere in the shop on the line. When you come to church, you must learn to stand. You can stand and make a line on the bank, but not before God. How long? What happened to you?
2 years.
What happened to you?
I work heavy equipment machines.
I get
an accident.
So I got a
2 years, yeah. Not working.
Yeah. Then I work with that.
Naiki samaya ki tusha kadi kota.
So you are free again. You
are free.
Glory to God. Glory
Amen.
To God.
Devil is behind you, Mama.
Satan only set you wrong.
I saw depths.
You wanted to call out to thing.
It's true, Pastor.
Huh?
It's true.
And Satan wanted to cry. Satan wanted to cry because by these depths, you are always thinking. You can't even pray now. You can't.
It's true.
So you are crying to God, God, I want to see a change.
So like,
by me coming here, God has done it.
Amen.
That is you. Where is your husband? Because I pain.
My husband is in Namibia.
Huh?
I'm come from Botswana. My husband is based in Namibia.
Is Namibia?
Papa uko Namibia.
So you didn't come with this one?
No.
Yes,
no.
You just come from Namibia.
I come from Botswana.
Botswana.
Yes,
I saw pain in your marriage.
Eh?
I saw pain. You are just holding this ring here. But there's no more marriage. So always, the husband was affected, I mean, by his spirit of lust.
Eh?
And you are finding out that he is turning around. So forgive your husband. He's still your husband. Eh? You hear me?
Amen.
Forgive your husband. I'll pray for you. There'll be restoration. Because Amen. You always think about divorce. Huh?
Yes.
Is it true?
Is it Pastor?
Huh?
Yes.
So don't divorce your husband. It's not him also. He has been attacked by evil spirit. A spirit of lust is upon him.
So
don't leave your husband because of a spirit of
Satan.
Stand with him. Let me touch. Come on. And this stomach of yours here, there's something moving here. So, come on. You're free. Come here. Come. This one. Come on. Come on, you demon, come on. Down, come on. You demon. This is a spirit in my sister.
Come on, you're moving, Moses.
What are you doing there?
So? Hey,
go down. Why are you changing this lady?
Why would you change her, Cecile?
What are you doing, my sister, here? Huh? Let me touch you there. Come on, you spirit of snake, come on. This is a snake. Move. Let me see how you move. Go away from where it's a snake. So she have got a spirit of snake inside. You're sleeping with a snake. Can you put your mic there? Come on, you demon. She's free.
Look, Lorraine.
Where are you working?
You better go.
I was not working.
Huh?
I'm not working.
You're not working. You want a job? So God loves you.
Amen.
That's why I'm asking you that question. God is blessing you.
Hey.
Come on. Hey, come on, move. There's a demon that is blocking this man. Can you see many of you have got demons that you don't know? Some demons are your friends and you don't know. Come on. What are you doing him?
I can't. Ah!
Ah! Ah! Come on, you demon. Leave, brother. Come on, move. Come on, move. Come on. You demon. Because he doesn't know you've got a demon. So when you wake up, he's there, you will know that.
So
you are free, rise up. Brother, were you aware you've got a demon?
Never.
Eh?
Oh, I never thought
never. So he's not even thinking, why you were not even
why
aware?
Listen,
I never thought I had a demon.
I want to pray for your phone.
Ricky Rappel Leng Funny.
I don't know where it is.
No, I want to pray for it because they are supposed to call you.
Can you go rappel like our batamil about phone? This is your
answer. I think it fell somewhere.
Can I know Rekabai which you can?
So you know you fell?
That's a bally wheel.
I think it was in my pocket.
It was in your pocket. God has blessed you with a job.
Amen.
My sister, come. You. Yes.
Lena.
Where is your husband? Come together. God wants to bless you. How many children do you have now?
No, we don't.
Nothing.
No.
That's why I'm calling you.
That's why I live here.
You want children?
Yes.
For how long?
From now.
No, I mean how long you were searching for children?
Married last year.
From last year?
Since last year.
You are searching for children. My brother, you have got low sperm count.
But low sperm count.
They've attacked you. Yourself here, they tie your womb. Always you feel pain here.
Yes. True, Pastor.
So you're going to have a baby girl.
Thank
come on. It's your firstborn. You're free.
The firstborn, you're laying.
Where is your husband?
Okay. Good night.
You want to marry?
Not at the moment.
Why?
Sing an
I
because I saw a strong disappointment that has hit your head.
Now disappointment ya usha patho.
And this makes you to say you can't marry.
Because I want to pursue my career. So
what is your career?
Career king.
I do business.
Yes? The business.
Why you don't want to marry? Because you want to pursue your career.
Yes.
Isn't it because of disappointment? Because I saw somebody disappoint you.
Is
it not true?
It is true.
Huh?
It is
true. I can't hear.
It is true.
So it's no issue of career. It's because you are disappointed. If the person didn't disappoint you, were supposed to have married.
Yes.
So God loves you. When you move from here, everything will change. Because you are disappointed. You are free.
Amen.
Where are you working?
I'm doing SMEs.
Huh?
SMEs at the hospital.
So I saw the money they are giving you. You are worried.
Yes.
Yes.
Because even where you are staying, you are not happy about where you are staying.
Yes, yes, it's true. It's true.
I can hear you.
Yes, it's true.
So if God is blessing you, you even move from where you are staying.
Yes.
So yes. You are blessed.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, come on, come on, come on. Let me touch you. You are free. Come. In your family, you have one problem. All of you, eyes. Yeah? All of you, eyes, eyes. This is an attack of failure. All of you are failing.
Amen.
The whole family is failing. Failing. Even you are struggling.
Amen.
Sometimes you say you don't know what to do.
Amen.
God is encouraging you.
Amen.
As I'm praying for you, I'm praying for the whole family. You are free. God loves you. God is healing you. Because sometimes you don't understand your feet. Always pains, pains. Yes. I can't hear.
Yes.
Who came with you here?
Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
You know when I say that, because she's always alone. Alone. Because of rejection. Alone, alone, alone. Sometimes she closes herself in the house.
Yes.
Yes.
Because people are, everybody is, even friends. So it's like they put a spirit of hatred on you. Yourself, you feel you're a failure. You're going to make it in life. Let me touch you.
Amen.
You're going to be a celebrity. You're going to be a celebrity.
Amen.
Can I touch your womb? You. Did you go to the doctor concerning your stomach?
When
they say disease that is eating you up. You don't know you are sick. If I give you a chance for checkup, and I pray for you, can I do that?
Yes.
Yes. Because there's a problem in your stomach. Always you feel cramps.
It's true.
Where is your boyfriend?
He's
here.
Where?
Oh, no. Surely.
Come. My brother. Because I'm hearing your boyfriend.
Boyfriend.
You are failing to marry.
You
try all means to marry this lady. Where you are aware she's sick. I didn't
know.
They have affection of you. You try to push her.
It's
true.
Because there's a cramp here. Cramp. Something that is, they are putting in their body. In her body when she's asleep. They wish this lady. Where did you get this lady? Because you speak Venda and you speak which language?
Pedi.
Where did you meet?
Otanga na bogai.
He right here in the church.
Were you not dancing Shakona?
Shakona Mithaila.
No.
Because this thing is for people who share corn. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Look at her. Can you see? She's free.
Amen.
You're free, says you are present. Yeah, together. Come.
Let's have my more.
You must stop fighting.
Okay.
Can I say it again?
Yes,
stop fighting. The way you are fighting is the story. Your relationship is changing.
Relationship is not true.
That's
eh?
True. That's true.
That's
true.
Sometimes you say she doesn't have respect.
That's true.
Is it true?
Yes.
So you must stop fighting. The way you are fighting, Satan is blocking you people.
Satan.
And in your family, there's a case.
That's
true, man of God.
Even here, when you are with this brother here, I'm not seeing marriage.
Did
he marry you?
We married and divorced and remarried again.
In your family?
Yes,
I said, this one, did he marry you?
Yes, he did marry me.
Yes.
Yes.
And when?
In 1996. And we divorced in 2010.
You were divorced?
In 2010 and remarried again.
He married again.
Yes.
It's a curse of your family.
It's a curse of your family.
It's a case of family because you can end up separating again. Because this lady was saying she doesn't see the importance of marriage.
That's true.
She told you.
Yes.
Eh?
Yes.
She told
so
you. This is a plan.
Keep plan
of separating you. There's a lady called Martha. Martha. Who's Martha?
It's my friend.
It's your friend. You must leave Martha. It's not good friend. You remember when you are together? She doesn't respect anybody.
Yes, it's true, man of God.
I can't hear you.
He's a man of God.
So that's where you took from Martha. Even you are like Martha now. So this brother is saying it that you don't respect anybody. So leave Martha.
To a Martha.
Come on. Come on, you demon. Go away from it. Out. Come on. Out. 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 Come on. You demon. Come on. Out. Out. Because I'm hearing this lady kissing you.
Okay, kwa bale roga.
That's true.
Yeah. So, it's what Martha does.
Into
Martha idea. Is how they speak. They speak incense. She's free. You must forgive her.
You
are healed. What happened to you?
Accident 12th April.
Accident of what?
Of car accident.
Car accident.
So you can't walk without crunches?
No.
No.
You can't walk at all.
Alekhono tsamale ya TT.
Where are the crutches? So why it's like it's four people?
Why you carry kichaba to babani?
Even this one?
Leo.
Even you are using crutches. What happened to you?
We're now the aging.
Accident. It's the same thing.
The same accident.
Yes. Same accident.
So you can see how Satan did it. You are healed. Give me one.
If we deal in pingity.
Two. You can move. You see, she's crying because she, you know, she can't walk.
Yes, you
were a good sipper.
She can't.
Thank you, Jesus.
So you believe you can walk too?
Because
that leg, she can't do what she's doing now.
You're
healed.
Hey.
Hey. Lift up. Put your leg down. Put your leg down.
Bang, look too fast.
Move down. Move.
Sipila.
Move.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
She's walking.
Bye, Sipila.
You see, she's walking.
Amen.
My sister, let me ask her. You can hear she's...
Thank you, God.
My sister, you could not do what you are doing.
I will pray with my children. When I wake up in the morning, I said, when I started to walk, I couldn't walk again. I'll go back and sleep again.
I was
in a taxi with my sister.
You people here, Linamo. Your healing is permanent.
Jesus loves you.
Jesus loves you.
Jesus
loves you. Jesus loves you. When I came here, I was coming here for this mama. It's only when I look at this. I never saw this issue of crunches. God told me that this lady, she's suffering. Nobody can help her.
You're
struggling.
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
I can't hear you.
Yes, man.
But it was not like that before. Everything has changed completely.
To make
zero.
Yes, man, of course.
Huh? So
it's
I was coming to you. I didn't know that these people. God wants to change your life. Everybody has run away from you.
Even my job is finished.
That's why I'm here.
That's why I kill him.
It's finished.
God
loves you.
Amen.
Well, thank you for restoring your life. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Let me pray for you, my brother. You are healed. You are free.
Amen.
You are free.
Amen.
You are free.
Amen.
You are free.
Amen.
Come, my brother. Look at this one. Hey. Look at this man's hand. What happened to your hand?
Papa. I cut myself with a knife. I was cutting a container. All of a sudden, it comes like this.
It's growing. Look at the hand there. My God. If you come this side here with your camera, just show the whole hand. You could see that this hand is going up like they can cut this hand. You were cutting container.
Yeah, I wanted to put petrol on my car. So I cut myself here with a knife. Then
so you can't do like...
No, it's not working.
You can't even do like this.
Yeah, I can only put... Look
at me. Jesus is healing you. Jesus
wali fodish.
You can see the vibration of this hand. Your hand is healed.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you,
Jesus. Brother, can you do it? Can you see it's coming now? More. It's coming more. Do
Amen.
It.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, I thank you. Thank you,
Amen.
Jesus. Oh, brother, you are free.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're free. 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 You are all free. Thank you. Thank you.
Amen.
Remember, we are not here for this today. You're free. You're free. You're free. You're free.
Amen.
You're free. What is important is what I'm telling you. You're free. You're free. You're free. You're free.
Amen.
You are free. You are free.
Amen.
You are free.
Amen.
You are free. What Amen. I'm telling you when I say you are free. Remember, I'm going to pray for everyone here today.
Amen.
So you are all free.
Take your house. Your house. You want a house? Take your house.